like to welcome everyone to the Peoria Speedway for our weekly Winston Racing Series NASCAR sanctioned stock car racing event. Tonight, a special occasion. It's the first night of our old-timers reunion. Tomorrow afternoon, we'll have the actual reunion with all of our old-time racer friends out here competing in some of the race cars. We'll have the old coupes. We'll have all kinds of racing going on tomorrow afternoon. In the little red convertible driven by Randy White, we've got our former pit steward, Dale Hoffman, sitting there in the front seat with Randy. Sam Rogers in the yellow shirt. In the back seat, Brownie used to help us out a whole bunch here at the Peoria Speedway and holding our POWMIA flag, none other than Jerry Rodell. These guys bring back a lot of great memories to all of us here at the Peoria Speedway. They're back with us tonight. They're all going to be with us here again tomorrow afternoon, and lots of other of our old-time friends will be with us. I think tonight, Dick Manuel's here, Bobby Rutledge is here, Jerry Bagby Sr., Jim Strube, Frank Fredericks, just to name a few. After a while, we'll get them all up here on the judges' stand and talk to them during our intermission period. And then tomorrow, our big annual old-timers reunion. At this time, we've got Larry Reeder Jr. out on the front straightaway in the 65 sportsman car. Larry's going to be carrying our American flag tonight in memory of his grandfather, Al Fredrickson, that passed away yesterday. Al was a World War veteran, and Larry just wanted to carry the flag around tonight in his memory, and we like that very much. Also, we'd like to say our good friend, Art Stevens, who used to be a pit steward here at the Peoria Speedway, passed away yesterday, and we're sorry to hear that. He was a good friend. We wish he could have been with us tomorrow, but things just didn't work out that way. Our condolences go out to the family, and tomorrow we'll do a little moment of silence for Art and his family here at our Old Timers Day. So racing fans, at this time, would you all please stand for the playing of our national anthem, and gentlemen, please remove your caps. Our first event of the evening in our Bomber Division, heat race number 1, 5 laps in distance. Starting on the front row, pole position, driving car number 22 is Chuck Barnes Jr. On the outside of row number 1, driving car number 77 is Scott Rhodes. Row number 2 on the inside, driving car number 69 is Ralph Davis. On the outside of row number 2, driving car number 71 is Jeff Schaub. Row number 3 on the inside, driving car number 48 is Tommy Halpin. On the outside of row number 3, driving car number 53 is Dan Goble. Row number 4 on the inside, in the 35 is Bob Goodman. On the outside of row number 4, in the 32T is Tony Fisher. Row number 5 on the inside, in the 68 is Wally Zander. And starting in that last position, driving car number 30 is Dave Dunbar. The clock on Donnie Beechler out here during the hot lap session Thursday night. He turned the quarter mile in 10.900 seconds. And keep your eye on turn number 4 to see if that green flag comes out. Five laps in distance. He makes number 1. Get off. Larson in the fourth position, the car 68 of Wally Zander in the third spot, the car 48 of Tommy Halpin in the number two position, the car 53 of Dan Goebel, and your winner of E-Race number one in our Bomber division, driving car number 22, sponsored by Barnes Racing, M&M Racing, Harmon Auto Parts, Duffy's Staff, and thanks to Shelley. About a great big hand for Chuck Barnes Jr. Our next event, he raced number two in our Bomber division, also five laps in distance, starting on the front row pole position. Driving car number 26 is Al Bill Jr. On the outside of row number one, driving the K9 is Keith Bull. Row number two on the inside, driving car number five is John Traver. On the outside of row number two, in the 31S is Chad Shire. Row number three on the inside, driving car number 36 is Ed Fisher. On the outside of row number three, driving the 104 is Roger DeLapp. Row number four on the inside, driving car number three is Jim Dillon. On the outside in the 02 is Coleman Alec. Row number five on the inside, driving car number 75 is Gary Rowe. On the outside of row number five, driving car number one is Phil Emery. And starting in that last position, driving car number 23 is Russ Hines. In the fourth position, the car number three of Jim Dillon. In the third spot, the car 31 of Chad Shire. In the number two position, the 02 of Coleman Alec. And the winner of E-Race number two in our Bomber division, driving car number five, sponsored by Ace Auto Parts, Discount Automotive, Edward Stapp, Mom and Dad, and Griffin Builders. How about a great big hand for John Traver? He raced number one in our sportsman division, starting on the front row pole position, driving car number 711 is Russell Spicer. On the outside of row number one, driving the F-13 is Don Traver. Row number two on the inside, driving car number 42 is Doug Seeger. On the outside of row number two, in the 82 is Stan Musgrave. Row number three on the inside, driving car number six is Reggie Weller. On the outside, in the 58 is Bill Rose. Row number four on the inside, in the 65 is Larry Reeder Jr. And starting on the outside of row number four, driving car number 32 is Gary Durr.
1 in our sportsman division, Rocco Spicer. Don Draver up there in row number 1. Doug Seeger. Stanley Musgrave back in row number 2. We're looking for that green flag. How does turn number 4?
In the fourth position, the F-13 of Don Draver. In the third spot, the 58 of Darrell Rose. In the number 2 position, the 65 of Larry Reeder Jr. And your winner of Heat Race number 1 in our sportsman division, driving car number 6 from East Peoria, sponsored by Reggie's Auto Body, the Katy Oil Company, Peoria Truck Wrecking, Brogan Fence and Feed, and P&G Electrical Rebuilders. About a great big hand for Reggie Weller. Our next event, Heat Race number 2 in the sportsman division, starting on the front row, pole position, driving the 007 is David Scow. On the outside of row number 1, in the 97 is Charlie Hess. Row number 2, on the inside, driving car number 13 is Jesse Griffin. On the outside of row number 2, in the 21J is James Minnell. Row number 3, on the inside, in the 9W is Brad Willis. On the outside of row number 3, in the 6T is Jason Plummer. Row number 4 on the inside, driving car 74 is Bill Sparks. And starting in that last position, driving car number 3 is Gary Sharp.
Cars all lined up in their proper positions over in turn number three. The yellow light is up. We're looking for that green flag out of turn number four. Finishing in the fourth position, the 9W of Brad Willis. In the third spot, the 21J of James Minnow.
In the runner-up position, the 97 of Charlie Hess. And the winner of Heat Race number 2 in our sportsman division, driving the 60 from Martinsville, Illinois, sponsored by Bird's Hot Shots Bar and Restaurant, Eddie Strickland Race Cars, Demas Hydraulics, Precision Automotive Machines, La Gondola Spaghetti House, Issues Auto Parts, Rockies on Farmington Road, and the Pizza Inn on Sterling Avenue. How about a great big hand for Jason Plummer? Apparently the J6P car of Jason Plummer has been disqualified, putting the 97 Charlie Hess in the first position. As soon as we find out why, we will let you know. And now we move on to our open wheel modified division. Heat race number 1, 10 laps in distance, starting on the front row pole position. Driving car number 44 is John Smith. On the outside of row number 1, driving car number 22 is Jeff Maher. Row number 2 on the inside in the 55B is Keith Pennycup. On the outside in the 33 is Robbie Robbins. Row number 3 on the inside in the 23T is Billy Tuckwell. On the outside in the 11B is Danny Irvin. Row number 4 on the inside, driving car number 7 is Rodney Bowman. And starting in that last position, driving car number 50 is Brent Pryor. Division. John Smith, Jeff Maher up there in row number 1, looking for the green flag out of turn number 4.
Now sitting up there in row number 1, Robbie Robbins. Billy Tuckwell in row number 2, Rodney Bowman, Danny Irvin in row 3, Brent Pryor, John Smith now in row number 4. No official laps complete, 10 laps remaining. He ranks number 1 in our modified division. Thank you.
finishing in the fourth position, the car 7 of Rodney Bowman. In the third spot, the 50 of Brent Fryer. In the number 2 position, the 22 of Jeff Maher. And your winner of B-Race number 1 in our modified division, driving the 23G from Spring Bay, Illinois, sponsored by Illinois Valley Towing, RC Motorsports, Harmon Auto Parts, Guys Bad Boys Club, the Silver Bullet Sports Bar and Grill, and Ricky Racer Collectible. Come on a big hand for Billy Tuckwell. Our next event, he race number 2 in our modified division, starting on the front row pole position in the C24, is Carl Bigger. On the outside of row number 1, driving car number 36 is Richie Standridge. Row number 2 on the inside in the J10 is Jerry Bagby Jr. On the outside of row number 2, driving car number 3 is Toby Sharp. Row number 3 on the inside in the 3M is J.R. McMahill. On the outside of row number 3 in the 55 is Darren Pennicum. On the outside of row number 4, driving the 69 is Chuck Taylor. And starting in that last position, driving car number 40 is Jerry Wallace. Richard in the fourth position, then Jay Tannis, Jerry Bagby Jr. in the third spot, the 3M of J.R. McMahill in the number two position, the 55 of Darren Pennycup. And your winner of heat race number two in our open wheel modified division, driving car number three from Peoria, sponsored by Jumer's Rock Island Casino, Dave's Pizza, Snap-on Tools, Mike's Auto Service, RC Motorsports, Paul's Pipe Shop, Intimate Towing, Villahand Race Engines, driving car number three, a great big hand for Toby Sharp. Our next event, heat race number one in our late model division, starting on the front row, pole position, driving the 72S is George Strotti. On the outside of row number one, driving car number 15 is Hope Shannon Jr. Row number two on the inside, driving car number 10 is Roger Reppel. On the outside of row number two, driving car number three is Rick Standridge. Row number three on the inside in the 82 is Denny Gray. On the outside in the 25 is Steve Lance Jr. Row number four on the inside in the 18K is Eric Cashagrow. On the outside of row number four in the 84 is Don Bolander. And starting on that inside position, row number five, driving car number 75 is Ray Gus Jr.
Thank you.
Christian in the fourth position, the car 15 of Herb Shannon Jr. In the third spot, the 25 of Steve Lance Jr. In the number two position, the car 75 of Ray Guest Jr. Sponsored by Precision Rebuild Auto, up and running truck and trailer repair, Velcro, Midwest Bullet, and Lapeza Inn on Sterling Avenue. Driving car number three, a great big hand for Rex Dandridge. Row number three on the inside, driving car 32 is Jake Wood. On the outside in the one axis, Mike Cochran. Row number four on the inside in the S10 is Frank Schickel Jr. On the outside in the T2 is Scott Bennett. Row number five on the inside in the 23W is Bob Wood. Finishing in the fourth position, the T2 of Todd Bennett. In the third spot, the 23 of Bob Wood. In the number two position, the car 14 of Duke Jackson. And your winner of heat race number two in our late model division, your current point leader here at the Peoria Speedway in our late model division, driving car number 32, sponsored by R.A. Benson Motorsports and the Hawkeye Chap in Davenport, Iowa. Out of Davenport, Iowa, how about a great big hand for Big Jake Willard? On the outside of row number one, Rick Standridge. On the inside of row number two, Jake Willard. On the outside of row number two, four cars for four laps in our late model dash for cash. Well, let's just do a little popularity contest. Who thinks Ray Gus Jr. is going to win this one? Let's hear it. About the 14 of Duke Jackson. How about Rick Standridge in car number three? Or the 32 of Rick Standridge? Ray Gus Jr. out in front in the 75 as we complete lap number one. From Milan, Illinois. How about a great big hand for Ray Gus Jr.? Ray Gus Jr. in fifth position in our season point battle in our late model division. Don Bowender in the fourth position with 196 points. In the third spot, Todd Bennett, 224 points in the number two position. Mike Cothran with 228 points. Jake Willard, your number one man in our late model division with 232 points. James Mennell, happy 28th birthday. I'll give you that card there. I think a whole bunch of people signed that. Don, you want to grab the cake over there? 28 years old, James drives car number 21J in our sportsman division. Got a real nice cake down here from all of his friends and a real nice birthday cake. Happy birthday to you, James. You got anything you want to say to these racing fans? No? Well, you could say thank you at least.
Yeah, I want to thank everybody for this, and thanks for all coming out to watch this race.
Thank you very much, James. And Don, I got something under here for you. Boy, I'll tell you what, look at this. Check this out. There's a note down here. To Don Traver, F13, from her fans. Yeah, show them up there. Hold them up there, show them what they are. Dawn got some roses from all of her friends. That's really nice, Dawn. Dawn drives the F-13 in our sportsman division. Congratulations to you. Maybe that's a secret admirer or something up there, Dawn. Anyway, we're moving on to our bomber feature event, 10 laps in distance. Our 50-50 drawing up to $720, $360 to win, guaranteed at this point. So you might want to pick up a 50-50 ticket, $360 at this point to win our 50-50 drawing. How about everybody in our bleachers? Let's all stand up and salute all of our bomber drivers as they head out of turn number four. Stand up and cheer and yell and shout and do what you want to do for your favorite driver as they head out of turn number four. Our salute to all of our bomber feature drivers. Bomber feature event. Up in that number one position with two laps complete. Ralph Davis in the number two spot in the third position. The car five is John Traver. Seven laps remaining in our bomber feature event. car number 3 from West Peoria, sponsored by A. Lucas & Sons, Baraka Tire, H. Hughes Auto Parts, Des Moines Paint Company, J.C. Dillon Plumbing, Interstate Batteries, Kinnick Body and Equipment, Maroons Auto Service, Mike's Cap, Daniel R. O'Brien, Attorney at Law, Party Time, Isaac Radiator, and River City Towing. How about a great big hand for Jim Dillon? Some fans, how about everybody standing up in our bleachers? Let's cheer, shout, yell, holler, stomp your feet, do whatever you want for our sportsman drivers as they pass out of turn number 4. This is our salute to all of our sportsman drivers. Row number 6 on the inside, driving car number 58 from Kent, sponsored by Monica Pizza. transition into fifth position, the car 58 of Darrell Rose. In the fourth spot, the car 6 of Reggie Weller. In the third spot, the 65 of Larry Reeder Jr. In the number 2 position, the 82 of Stan Musgrave. And your winner of our 15-lap sportsman feature event, driving car number 97 from Peoria, sponsored by Hank Wrenchy, Baldwin Filters, Swepco Oil, Redding Swimming, Randy's 3-in-1 Shop, Eddie Strickland Racing Chassis, Charlie Herman Auto Salvage, Hess Trucking, Dave's Pizza, Uncle Dick's Custom Cycle Shop, and Struby's Auto Repair. And I think we got a winner in our 50-50 drawing of $489. And believe it or not, it's one of our old-timers, Bobby Rutley, zone number 52 out at the Mount Holly Speedway. We'll verify the ticket. Okay, 157-6061. That's the one. Congratulations, Bobby Rutley. You're $489 richer. I bet you're glad you came this year, aren't you? You got it. Thank you, Bobby. As he pulls into Victory Circle and climbs out of his car, how about a great big hand for Charlie Hess? Okay, everybody in our bleachers, let's everybody stand up and salute all of our modified drivers. As they pass out of turn 4, everybody stand up and cheer for your favorite driver. Our salute to all of our modified feature drivers. John Smith. driving car number 3 out from Triboli. Sponsored by RC Motorsports, Neil Auto Parts, McMahill Auto Body, DeBoer & Paint Company, Automotive Machine, River City Towing, Peoria Truck Wrecking, Koenig Body and Equipment, Bemis Hydraulics, J&S Motorsports Collectibles, and Cartville, USA. As he climbs out of his car, how about a great big hand for J.R. McMahill? Finishing in the 10th spot, the car 50 of Brent Breyer. In the 9th position, the car 7, Rodney Bowman. In the 8th position, the 33 of Robbie Robbins. In the 7th spot, the 44 of John Smith. In the 6th position, the 11D of Danny Irvin. In the 5th position, the 55 of Darren Pennycup. In the 4th spot, the 23D of Billy Tuckwell. In the 3rd position, the 22 of Jeff Maher. In the number 2 position, the car 3 of Toby Sharp. Also, you can take your ticket stubs and pit passes up there tonight. $3 off a large, $2 off a medium pizza, the Pizza Inn on Sterling Avenue. How about everybody standing up? Let's salute all of our late model drivers as they pass out of turn number 4. Stand up and cheer for your favorite driver. Our salute to all of our late model feature drivers. Don't forget, next Saturday night, it's Gatorade night right here at the Peoria Speedway. Our late model feature, 40 laps in distance. Gates open at 5, racing at 7 next Saturday night. position in the 10th position, the one X of Mike Cochran, and the 9th spot, the 23W of Bob Hood. In the 8th position, the S10 of Frank Schickel Jr. In the 7th spot, the 25, Steve Lance Jr. In the 6th position, the 21, Bob Pistol. In the 5th spot, the 32 of Jake Willis. In the 4th spot, the T2, Todd Bennett. In the 3rd position, the 82, Denny Gray. In the number 2 position, the car 3 of Rick Standridge. And your winner of our 30-lap weight model feature event, driving car number 75 from Marlin, Illinois. How about a great big hand for Ray Goss, Jr.?